described in that I am Lord Bracknell, which will allow my only daughter, a girl brought up with the utmost care, to marry into Clover and from the lands of the parcel. Good morning, Mr. Worthing.
Good morning.
As far as Gwendolyn is concerned, we are engaged. Her mother is perfectly unbearable. Never met such a Gorgon. I don't really know what a Gorgon is like, but I'm quite sure that Lady Bracknell is one. I beg your pardon, Algie. I suppose I shouldn't talk about your own aunt in that way before you.
I love hearing my relations abused. It is the only thing that makes me put up with them at all.
You don't think Gwendolyn's going to become like her mother in about 150 years, do you, Algie?
All women become like their mothers. That is their tragedy. No man does, that's his.
Is that clever?
It's perfectly phrased. By the way, did you tell Gwendolyn about the truth about your being Ernest in town and Jack in the country?
The truth isn't the sort of thing one tells to a nice, sweet, refined girl.
Okay, then. What about your brother? What about the profligate Ernest?
Oh, by the end of the week, I shall have got rid of him. I'll say he died in Paris by a severe chill.
Won't Miss Carter feel this loss a great deal?
Oh, that is all right. Cecily is not a silly romantic girl, I'm glad to say. She's got a capital appetite, goes long walks, and pays no attention at all to her lessons.
I would rather like to see Cecily.
I'll take very good care you never do. She is excessively pretty, and she is only just 18.
Have you told Gwendolyn yet that you have an excessively pretty woman who is only just 18?
Oh, one doesn't blurt these things out to people. Cecily and Gwendolyn are perfectly certain to become extremely great friends. I'll bet you anything that half an hour after they have met, they will be calling each other sister.
Women only do that when they have called each other a lot of other things first. Now, dear fellow, if you want to go to the spot at Willis's, we must go and dress. Gwendolyn, upon my word!
Algie, kindly turn me back, for I have something very particular to say to Mr. Worthing.
Really, Gwendolyn, I don't think I can allow this.
Algie, you always adopt a strict, immoral attitude towards life. You're not quite old enough to do that yet. Ernest, we may never be married. From the expression on the woman's face, I fear we never shall. But although she may keep us from becoming man and wife, and I may marry someone else, and marry often, nothing that she can do can alter my eternal devotion to you.
Dear Gwendolyn,
the story of our romantic origin, as related to me by Mama, has stirred the deeper fibers of my nature. Your town address at the Albany I have. What is your address in the country?
The Manor House, Woolton, Hertfordshire.
I will communicate with you daily. Algie, you may turn around now.
Thanks, I've turned around already.
You may also ring the bell.
I will see Miss Fairfax out.
Lane, a glass of sherry, please.
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow, Lane, I'm going bunburying.